Hello students, so today we will be studying loop antenna. I would discuss loop antenna, its basics, then types of loop antennas, the properties of loop antennas, its radiation pattern. All these things shall be discussed by me in today's lecture. Okay, so let us start with the topic. Loop antenna. Okay, so this is the outline of today's lecture. We will be discussing the basics of loop antenna. Okay, basics of loop antenna, then types of loop antenna. Types of loop antenna. Now in this topic, that is the types of loop antenna, we will be discussing basic two types of loop antenna, and those are the small loop antenna and the large loop antenna. We will be seeing the radiation pattern of both of them and its structural specification and its property. These all things will be discussed by me in detail in this lecture. Okay, so this was the second point of today's topic. The third is radiation. Radiation, as I told you earlier, radiation of loop antenna, that means radiation of both the antennas, that is the small antenna, small loop antenna, and a large loop antenna, as well as we will see the structural specifications, structure of loop antenna, and then we will see properties of these two antennas. Okay, and then at the end we will see few basic applications of the loop antenna. So the last point of today's lecture will be applications. Applications of loop antenna. Okay, now let us begin with the basics of loop antenna. Okay, loop antenna is a simple conductor in loop. Okay, we can say that that is, if you consider any conductor wire and convert it into any loop, that turns into a loop antenna. That is a simple structural definition, I will say, for the loop antenna. And of course we need to give some feed to it. So the feed to the loop antenna could be a coaxial cable or it could be any transmission line. Okay, now let us have a let us look at different shapes of loop antennas. Okay, so the possible shapes could be a rectangular shape. Okay, it could be a rectangular shape loop antenna. That means you can turn any wire into a rectangular shape. This is where you will give the feed. Okay, or where you will connect the transmission line, which will act as a excitation point. Okay, it could be a circular loop antenna. or it could be a triangular loop antenna. Okay, it could be any shape loop antenna basically. Okay, and this, at this point of time, we are using or we will be considering a wired loop antenna. Okay, loop antennas could be a planar loop antennas also, that is microstrip loop antennas are also present, so that could be seen later. As this chapter is confined to the basic structure and the basic properties, basic working of the loop antenna, so let us only look at the wired loop antennas in detail. Okay, now if we have a coaxial cable as a feed to the loop antenna, then how it goes, let us see how will we connect a coaxial cable to a loop antenna when it is used as a feed. Say suppose this is one of the end, then one end is connected to the inner conductor and another end is connected to the outer conductor of a coaxial cable. So this one is a inner conductor, inner conductor, and this one is a outer conductor. Okay, similarly you can do it with any shape of antenna. So one end to the inner conductor, the other end to the outer conductor, and so on. Okay, here goes, here it goes. Okay, now after this, the your antenna will start radiating. Now we will discuss different shapes, and then we will see how it differs with respect to each other, how they how their radiation pattern, how their properties differ with respect to each other. Okay, now we will consider the very first shape which we have drawn over here, that is a rectangular shape. Okay, so say suppose this is a rectangular loop antenna. Okay, here this loop antenna basically acts as a dipole. Okay, this is one dipole. Okay, this is another dipole, this is another dipole, and this one is another dipole. That means this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. That means this one loop antenna acts like different dipoles, and whatever radiation pattern I get out of this loop antenna will be the resultant of all this dipole. Okay, so its radiation will be radiation pattern will be the resultant of all these individual dipoles in a loop. Okay, individual dipoles but in one loop. Okay, now we will discuss about for circular loop antennas, that I will discuss when we will be discussing the large loop antennas and their properties. Right now let us focus on the triangular loop antenna. Okay, say suppose this is a triangular loop antenna. Okay, now in this case we have this one dipole. Okay, this one dipole, that is the axis, and this one. So its resultant radiation pattern will be combination of all these dipoles, and then I will get a resultant pattern. Okay, of all this dipole, 1, 2, and so on. Okay, So these were the basics of loop antenna. Now let us discuss types of loop antennas. Our next point was types of loop antenna. Okay, as I told you earlier, there are basically there are two types of loop antennas. Number one, small loop antenna, and second one, large loop antenna. Okay, now first let us see or discuss in detail the small loop antenna. Small loop antenna, okay. Small loop antenna. Small loop antenna is defined as when overall length of the loop is less than lambda by 10, then it is called as small loop antenna. Okay, so what is the definition of small loop antenna? When the overall length of the loop is less than lambda by 10, then it is called as a small loop antenna. Okay, or another thing, if the loop antenna is having n number of turns, okay, then in that case, for n turn loop antenna, specifically circular loops, okay, this is specifically for circular loops, then n into 2 pi r should be less than lambda by 10. Okay, so if it is a single loop circular loop antenna, then the overall length of the loop should be less than lambda by 10, and if it is a n turn loop antenna, then n, that is number of turns, into 2 pi r for a circular loop should be less than lambda by 10. Okay, now let us discuss about the properties of small loop antennas. Property of a small loop antenna. The very first property is null must be perpendicular to plane of loop. Okay, this is the very first property. Let me explain you this one in detail. Okay, the null must be perpendicular, or null is perpendicular to the plane of the loop. Let me explain you that. Say suppose this is a circular loop antenna. Okay, this is its top view. This is the top view. So obviously this will be the side view. Okay, a simple line or a simple wire will be viewed as a side view. Okay, now as the property tells us that the null is perpendicular to the loop. The null is perpendicular to the loop means this is the null. It is perpendicular to the plane of the loop. Okay, so this is your null and your radiation pattern goes this way. Okay, it goes this way. Okay, here the null is perpendicular to the plane of the loop. Okay, and the radiation goes this way. Say suppose this is a loop antenna and this is how your plane goes. Okay, this way. Okay, and in association, in accordance with that, you will get this kind of radiation pattern. Okay, now the another property is for the small loop antenna is it has got less radiation resistance. Since the radiation resistance is less, obviously our radiation efficiency will also be less. Okay, less radiation resistance, less radiation efficiency. Now let us discuss, before that, one more thing I would like to tell you when it is up to the loop antennas, specifically for small loop antennas. Supposing I consider a circular loop with the dimension R, that is a radius R. Okay, and if I consider a rectangular loop antenna with dimensions D, say suppose, okay, this is D and this is D, then area for this loop, circular loop, say if it is A1, then it will be pi r square, and area for rectangular, say suppose A2, will be A2 is equals to D square. Okay, if A1 is equals to A2, okay, then the radiation in both the cases will be same. Okay, if A1 is equals to A2, then radiation will be same. Okay, so these were the properties and some of the facts for small loop antenna. Now let us discuss large loop antennas. Okay, large loop antennas. Antenna. Okay, so when the overall length of the loop is about lambda, then it is called as large loop antenna. Okay, so this is the definition of large loop antenna, that is when the overall length of the loop is about lambda, that is equal to or nearby equal to lambda, then it is called a large loop antenna. Okay, so the properties of large loop antenna. Okay, the properties are that the radiation, or it radiates perpendicular to plane of loop. Okay, in previous case, that is small loop, the null was perpendicular to the plane. Here the radiation will be perpendicular to the plane of the loop. Okay, consider a small loop, okay, circular loop antenna. Say suppose this is a top view, okay, and this is a side view, of course, side view. Okay, then the radiation will be perpendicular to the plane, as in this is a plane, this is a perpendicular to the plane, and your radiation will go this way. Okay, so perpendicular radiation, perpendicular to the plane. In the previous case, it was null perpendicular to the plane. So as we say that the small loop radiation pattern looks like a end fire antenna. If you can see, it looks, the radiation of the small loop antenna looks like a end fire antenna. Okay, see it carefully. Whereas the radiation of the large loop antenna looks like a broadside radiation pattern, or have the radiation perpendicular to the plane. Okay, now the second property, it has got, that is the large loop antenna has got relatively high radiation resistance, therefore obviously it will have high radiation efficiency, high radiation efficiency. Okay, now let us move. This was all about the small loop antenna, its property, okay, its radiation pattern. Now let us move on to the applications of the loop antenna. Applications of loop antenna. Okay, it has its application in high frequency ranging from 3 to 30 megahertz. Okay, here the size of the loop is very large. In this case, the size of the loop has to be very, very large. Okay, it also has its application in very high frequency ranging 30 to 300 megahertz. It works also efficiently in ultra high frequency ranging 300 to 3000 megahertz. Okay, it also have many applications in microwave frequency, okay, ranging from 1 gigahertz to 100 gigahertz. But one thing has to be remembered, that these all application must be for low gain. Okay, for low gain. Okay, so this was all about loop antenna. Okay, the basics, its properties, its radiation pattern. So if you have any doubt in whatever we have seen today, you can contact me. ओके थैंक यू.